Being a system administrator can be frustrating. Sometimes it's difficult to find a root cause when things go wrong. And the truth is, some problems you can't actually resolve. You just have to find a workaround. Here's a story of one such problem and how a hunch can be one of the greatest assets for a system administrator.
My name is Matija. I work in a group of companies that does mainly manufacturing of raw materials and building materials.
One of the companies Matija supports produces cement, and they have an automated loading process. The loading area consists of four lanes, so four trucks can be loaded at the same time. How it works: trucks come into the loading area, park in the designated zone, and the drivers place an RFID card into a reader. The automation process then starts and cement is loaded onto the truck. Scales underneath the truck measure how much of the product has been loaded onto the truck, and when a targeted weight is reached, the loading stops. The loading time is approximately 15 minutes, so every 15 minutes, a truck is loaded with a few thousand euros worth of cement. Because the automation process is central to keeping the loading running smoothly, any issues can have costly results.
The effects of the automation process stopping is a considerable slowdown in the loading process. We have to do it manually. So instead of loading four trucks every 15 minutes, we could maybe load one or two in every half an hour.
To keep the automated loading system up to date with the newest technologies, the company had recently updated the legacy hardware and software that it ran on. The project involved setting up new servers and new PLC SCADA controllers and then connecting everything together. While external vendors were responsible for the new software, provisioning the new hardware and operating system was the role of the IT department.
Well, we received a specification of hardware requirements for the new servers, and just on a hunch, we provided double that.
Despite providing more hardware than required, the new automated loading system ran into problems almost immediately. After about a week of smooth operation, the system started to slow down. It gradually became slower and slower until it ground to a halt. So Matija did what any sysadmin would do in his situation.
The response was to restart the server. And when we restarted it, we solved it. It caused some minor delays in our loading process, but not a showstopper. But it was time to investigate why did it act the way it acted.
As is often the case with these things, the conversation went back and forth. The response from the vendors responsible for the software was that perhaps it was an operating system configuration issue, or maybe an antivirus software scanning issue. Maybe it was the SIEM system they'd implemented causing the slowdowns and delays. At this point, Matija had two hunches. First, he didn't believe that anything mentioned by the software vendors were actually causing the problem. And second, he thought the problem might occur again.
And then about that time, I decided to give PRTG a shot and put some sensors with performance counters into our monitoring system.
Paessler PRTG monitoring software lets you monitor just about anything in your IT infrastructure, including Windows servers.
So in order to get some further insights in what's going on under the hood of the operating system, we've added some sensors to PRTG, particularly Windows process sensors that out of the box have a handle counter implemented, and PRTG started monitoring the handle usage by some processes that we've identified as the vendor's solution. The PRTG, after a week or so, clearly showed that the handle count is rising and not coming down. At the height of this issue, we had some 4 million handles opened by a single process. That was a lot.
Here's a very simplified explanation of what handles are. Software programs and operating systems use handles as reference links to objects managed by external systems. They remain in memory until not needed anymore, at which point they're let go. In Matija's case, they weren't being let go and were using up memory. With the knowledge that the vendor's software was responsible for the buildup of handles, he could go back to the vendor to investigate more. And as it turned out, the problem was not with the vendor's code itself, but rather with a component that the vendor used to implement the system. It was up to the vendor's partner to patch their component. But in the meantime, Matija had to find a workaround for the issue. A server reboot every weekend would clear the handles and avoid costly downtime. Then, during the week, PRTG could make sure an unexpected buildup of handles didn't occur.
So the thing that PRTG helped with was monitoring the handle usage and setting up a certain threshold to alert our system administrators and our vendors that the handle consumption and memory consumption is getting high and that they need to plan a server reboot to keep our system running.
According to Matija, using monitoring software helped to find the root cause and avoided having to argue with multiple departments and vendors about what the problem might be. But in addition to this, there was another benefit too.
One other thing the RTG helped besides saving time was to help prove that throwing more hardware at our problem wouldn't solve it.
So what did Matija learn from his experience?
It's not always an operating system or system administration issue. It can be a lot of stuff. PRTG allowed us to peek under the hood and see what really was going on. Sometimes we just depend on the quality of other people's products and we cannot fix them all, but we can see what's going on and then mitigate it and work around it.
To learn more about the sensors that Matija mentioned and about PRTG, visit the links in the video description. And do all the things that people on YouTube like when you do them, like this video, subscribe to this channel, and click bell icons.